So this video is to help us as Dengoni people to trace our own origin or our own genesis. This comes from the TV show Sankofa, hosted by Mr. Bishop Joshua Mapong. This is the Knowledge King Dengoni Gede, gives us as the nation of the Igbo people. This is powerful knowledge outside the mainstream religious teachings. If this is your first time coming across this knowledge, I highly recommend you go to the Sankofa YouTube channel and watch the show for better understanding of this knowledge. Thank you to Bishop Joshua Maponga and King Dengoni Gede for this knowledge. So let's begin. So King Dengoni Gede puts it like this, right? So in the beginning, Umvelinqangi, the Ancient of Days, God himself, creates the world. And after he creates the world, then he creates the first two people. He draws them out of the waters with reeds, Emhlanyeni. Then he names the man Udlomo. So we don't get the name of the wife, but he names the man Udlomo. So Mvelinqangi makes them the caretakers of the whole world. He makes them the custodians of the whole world. Then he blesses them and tell them, be fruitful and multiply. So the first couple have their first child. They welcome their first child. They name the child Umkhize. Then they have their second child. Then they name him Ukhumalo. Then they have the third child. Then they name him Umbele. So it gets interesting when we reach the fourth child, because they name the fourth child Ubhuqwa, right? So this is whereby you can say Dlomo himself gives the blessings to Ubhuqwa. He gives them the stick to say that he's gonna be the leader of their people. So Dlomo names the fourth child Ubhuqwa. So what is Ubhuqwa? So Ubhuqwa is whereby you take a newly born child, an infant, to the river. When you get to the river, you take the mud or the clay, you smear it on the baby, then you wash it off with the river's water. Then after that, you wrap the child with the leopard skin. So this connects the child to the waters where the first two people came from. So Dlomo gathers all his children and tell them that all the children born to them have to go through this ceremony or this ritual. So this is actually where the name comes from, Ubhuqwa.
Your name is your shield, and I will name you Khize, which means stay put, but not stay slave. Khize, you are the daughter of Kunta Kinte, the daughter of Bel. And though you will never know them, granddaughter of Omoro and Binta Kinte. Allahu Akbar! Behold!
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 The only thing greater than you.
As Dlomo's children starts multiplying on the face of the earth, from the one who got the leadership position, Ubhuqwa, he fathers a child and he names him Ngelengele. Then Ngelengele also starts having his own children, and his firstborn becomes Uthibi. Then Uthibi is followed by a brother called Ulubelo. Then the young brother after Ulubelo becomes Ubusobengwe. Then Ubusobengwe is followed by Umazibuko. The most important information I forgot to share about this history is that all this is taking place in Congo. So we can say that in this history, Congo is the cradle of the human race. So this is where we all began. So as the people start growing in numbers, they keep multiplying. Then they start to migrate around Africa. They move from Congo to Angola, to Zambia, to Zimbabwe, looking for greener pastures. They keep moving south until they find themselves in the Zambezi River, and all of them decide on crossing the river to the other side. They all hold hands, creating a chain, so they can all cross at once. They get into the waters, moving slowly towards the other side. As the current of the water gets strong, breaking the chain they created with their hands, a group of people is swept away by the waters to a far distance land. and these people are with Uchibi, so they automatically put him in the leadership position simply because he's the eldest of them all. And Uchibi becomes the father of Uthembu and Uxhosa. And we go back to the main group. Is another group that is swept away by the waters. So these people are the Tswana people of today. Then we get back to the main group, and they manage to cross the river to the other side. And they are led by Ubuso Bengwe, who was given the leadership position by his father, Ungelenge. Then they move to Zimbabwe and manage to cross the Limpopo River. Then they live in Mpumalanga. They all assemble as one big family. This is still the same people from the Congo. There's no Zulu, Akothosa, Auna Mosutu, Agna Shangane. They are just one big family. The Embo people, Abantu Bango, just one big tribe. There's no division amongst them. Buso Bengwe then fathers a child, and he named this child Udlamini. So funny background story behind the surname Udlamini is that they say Ubuso Bengwe used to walk out of meetings. They say there's men gathering. He would just stand up and just leave them there and get inside his crawl. And him and his wife would start doing the pata-pata. So that's a joke. The elders said that the child that's going to be born from this pata-pating has to be called Dlamini, because Ubuso and the wife would do it during the day. That's where the background story behind the surname Dlamini comes from. Then Dlamini is followed by a brother called Umhlanga. Just a background clarification of Umhlanga. We know that from the beginning of the story, Umvelinqangi drew two people from the river with reeds and Mhlangeni. We know that water is pure, and the reeds also symbolizes purity. That's why Dlamini was known as the king of Mhlangeni. Every year we see celebrations of Mhlangeni, young vision girls holding reeds to present to the king. Traditionally, this is a celebration of Dlamini, Inkosi yaseMhlangeni, the king yaseEmbo. Then Ubuso Bengwe names his second born Umhlanga as a remembrance of where the first two people came from. Ubuso Bengwe's third child became Umsimango, and the fourth child became Utaba, and the fifth child became Umti Omkhulu. Then Udlamini and Umhlanga moved out of the group. They went out looking for greener pastures, and this is where they met their cousin Utembe. So they settled together and lived in a place called Watembe today, and this is where they multiplied rapidly again. So then Utembe told them that they have become so many, they have to move ngale kwelibombo. And this, as they moved across kwelibombo, they met another cousins, abakwaSimelane, and this is how the Swaziland was established. And of course the role of the leader went to Udlamini as the eldest amongst the group. With Dlamini and Mhlanga gone, Umsimango and Xaba thought they will assume power when Ubuso Bengwe joins their ancestors. But the kingship went to the youngest, Umti Omkhulu, who was chosen by God, Umvelinqangi. We're no longer dealing with leadership positions whereby the eldest gets to rule. Now we are dealing with kingship, and the kingship is chosen by God himself, Umvelinqangi. Umti Omkhulu then fathers a child, and he names him Uzikode. Then Uzikode, when he grows up, he is given a place to rule. Today is called Petersburg. That's where he ruled until he had a child, and he named the child Ungqobo. Then we go back eSwatini. We learn that Umhlanga fathered a child called Umusi. And Umusi is known today as Umusi kaMhlanga. After the death of his father, Umusi moved back to eMthonjeni weGwa, and he lived there. And he also lived eMhlangeni, the place called eMhlangeni today. And Umusi also lived in eTswane, a place called Etswane today. Actually, Uzigode became a father of Ungobo and Uhadebe. He had two sons, Ungobo and Uhadebe, and Ungobo became the king. So what was messed up about Ungobo is that every time he fathered the male child, he would kill that child, preventing a successor. So the nation had enough of Ungobo's behavior, so they decided on getting him drunk, and he was taken by the hunters to the forest, where he was left for dead and was killed by wild animals. With Ungobo dead, Hadebe was told to resurrect his brother's house. He was to have children with his brother's widow. Her name was Lomahlubi. Hadebe and Lomahlubi had a child, and they named that child Udlomo, resurrecting the name of the first human being. All the children born from Uhadebe and Lomahlubi didn't want to be associated with Ungobo because of all the murders he committed. So they went with their mother's name, Ulomahlubi. They are the Amahlubi people of today. All this is taking place Kwamsinga. When Udlomo the second grows up, he's told that Uhadebe Ibambela is the one who's holding the kingship for him, and he's the one who's to be crowned king. And Uhadebe didn't have a problem with handing over the kingship to Udlomo the second. He proposed they should do it the proper way, with rituals and a ceremony to let people know that Udlomo the second is now taking over his rightful place on the throne, the kingship. On the day of crowning the new king, King Udlomo the second, Hadebe's young brother was not thrilled about the idea, so he took dogs and he went out hunting, hence the saying, Wakunga izinja wayozingela. When people told Hadebe what was his brother doing, Hadebe was not bothered about the fact that his young brother was leaving for the hunt, and he was quoted saying, "Me again, kuyoba umdlulu umakhunga izinja kuyodlulwa izinto." This is where we get the surname of the Mdlulis. Then Hadebe finds it difficult living in that environment after handing over the kingship to Udlomo the second. Then Hadebe moves to the Eastern Cape, and the history also informs us that Uhadebe was the first king to rule in Natal in the year 1500. Remember, Uchibi is the one who houses the Xhosa tribes. King Bongani III references for us a book called Iziduko Zamahlubi, written in 1938, and it was produced in 1939, just to verify this knowledge. Then we go back to Udlomo the second. He fathers a child and he names him Umashiya, and Umashiya fathers a child and he names him Untsele. Untsele then fathers a child and he names him Ubungani the second. Then Ubungani the second has a brother called Umuwayile. Umuwayile then goes out looking for greener pastures, and he ends up in a small village, and this is where we get the Sotho people, and he's well accepted by the village people, and the chief has a liking to him. The chief of this village has three sons, and the oldest of his sons is the one who's married and the heir to the throne. But as Umuwayile starts living in this village, he's the one who's working hard, who's taking out the cows, who's milking the cows, he's out in the fields, he's just doing everything, and these three sons are just, they were lazy. So time goes by and the older brother passes away. So the chief decides that one of his younger sons is gonna have to resurrect the big brother's house. But this woman was not having it, like they didn't want to have a child by these younger brothers. So he asked for permission to have a child by Muwayili. The chief agreed, but he told them that all this banging will have to take place outside of his kraal, out of respect for his dead son. I'm gonna cut this video here. I'll call this one part one. There'll definitely be a part two. So if you liked the video, please leave a like and subscribe, And if you think I have potential, still please leave a like and subscribe. Thank you very much. See you on the next video.